in beating these Tampa Bay Lightning in a 5-3 hockey game. Face-off underway, Point and Bedard. And again, a ton of high-end talent on the ice between these two teams. Kept in by Purbix. Centering feed, but Marilla couldn't tee it up. Ryan Donato back the other way for Chicago. Let's it go! Johansson's in the game. Makes the first big stop of the hockey game.
About Andre Vasilevsky in the net is that, yeah, the Jonas Johansson who's played most of the games and, you know, he's just not Vasilevsky. So you can't give him high D.
Isamot along the wall. Swings it back for Chernik. That shot was stopped by Mrazek. I'm not sure he saw that coming. Janot pokes it a little deeper. That's off the outside of the pipe by Isamot.
Put some juice in this building if they can find a way to score.
Reichel will play the bumper on this power play. Here's Bedard, centers in front, and he got the stick down. Hagel on it, centers through with speed. Sorelli, short-handed, big save, Peter Mrazek, to keep it scoreless.
Maybe what we needed was a Blackhawk power play. Chances at both ends.
That's right. Seth Jones will leave it. Bedard through center with speed. Got it through. Here's Kurashev. Tried to go through the dots for Reichel. Blackhawks haven't been able to really set things up. Corey Perry will go net front presence. Korchinski swings it off. Looking for the redirect and the score! It's Lucas Reichel! His first goal of the season comes on the power play. And it's 1-0 Chicago.
Lucas Reichel is in the bumper position, the middle of the ice on the Blackhawks power play. No goals on the season. They want him to be more involved. They need him to be more involved offensively. So they figure if they get him in the middle, he's going to have more touches on the puck. It's a heads-up play from Kurashev. This is a shot past the deflection.
Shot blocked at the defense. Good job there by Chernik. Racing in, Kucherov trying to center in front. Brayden Point whacking at it, can't beat Mrazek.
And all of a sudden, Nikita Kucherov is a problem everywhere as he rushes the net.
Tries the side of the net, here's Point. He'll go back to the point. Purbix lets it go, that shot is stopped by Mrazek with crazy traffic in front of the net. And that power play had been 5-46 on the season. And able to strike here and get the lead.
Man, Corey Perry's had a nice night, too.
Here's a chance. Here's Mott breaking in. He shoots, and Mrazek the save. Mott trying to go short side. And another glove save. Mrazek will gobble that one up. He's on it now. He'll go back to the point there. There's Kucherov. Point in the bumper. Paul net front presence. Hedman lets it go. Shot to score. Brayden Point on the power play. And the Lightning have tied the game at one.
This looks a lot like Lucas Reichel's goal in the first period for Chicago. Tampa gets the puck. Watch this nice work on the wall here by Nick Paul as he's going to have to dig it off the wall and make a nice little pass back to Kucherov. Two passes later, it's Brayden Point's deflection off the Hedman shot. Man, these three guys have been in a lot of goals together. Kucherov to Hedman to Point. Mrazek can't catch up to it through that Nick Paul screen. What I liked was Paul started the play here in the corner, and then he gets to the front to help the traffic in front of Mrazek.
Hey, Ray, it looks like there's some conversation going on at that Chicago bench.
If that's the play they're looking at, the question will be whether Point is in control of the
right
puck. As the puck hits his stick.
Initiated by Chicago is termed, it was a good goal. Chicago has assessed a delay of game bench minor.
Knocked out of midair by Nick Foligno. And some pressure, Entwistle pressuring Hedman there. Entwistle stays on it. To the front of the net. That shot blocked out the defense. Here's Sergachev, catches glass. Chernik will roll up for it. Goes off the stick there of Phillips. I think it's set up pretty well here. Sergachev shot, score! And it goes through a maze of players and in. And for the first time tonight, the Tampa Bay Lightning have the lead, 2-1.
Didn't have a goal yet this year, and Sergachev starts this play with a long shot. The Lightning retrieve it. They win the puck around the boards. They win it back behind the net as Stamkos keeps this play alive. A nice little touch pass to Point, and there's the traffic. And it's traffic in front. It's Sergachev's first, and it's 2-1 Tampa lead.
Connor Murphy and a big hit. We're going to get a scrap. Connor Murphy and Mikhail Esamod going at it back behind the play. Murphy had a big hit in the corner, and Esamod looking to stick up for his teammates there.
So there's the hit on Janot, and Esamont is going to come into the play, and this is the result of it.
And as you know, Ray, Janot is a guy who can handle his own business. With three fighting majors, he's tied for the NHL lead in this young season.
And Janot's a throwback. It's 2-1 lead heading into the third period.
That's our game flow brought to you by Progressive. As we get a quick whistle, Dickinson comes over to help out. Worked free to Hedman. Kucherov tried the one-timer. Chicago looks to counter and break. Corey Perry has got some help. Try to swing it across in front side of the net. Tic-tac-toe! And it's Corey Perry who finishes off a brilliant Chicago setup. And the Blackhawks have tied the game at two.
Starts on a turnover inside the Tampa offensive line as Kucherov turns it over. Now it's a two-on-one. Hedman back. Pressure coming to the middle of the ice, and Dickinson is going to deflect this puck over towards Corey Perry, who's now standing a foot and a half from the net. Nice little touch pass, and there's no chance for Johansson there. As
Kaiser came over to free him from the puck. The Lightning jump on it. Here's Brayden Point with a step on his backhand. Stopped by Mrazek and the rebound as well. And Bedard spending a lot of energy in the shift in his own end, Ray. It's a critical piece. Chernak swings it across for Hedman. Goes back. Chernak in traffic. Mrazek never saw it, and the bounce off the end boards, and it's in. Victor Hedman has put Tampa Bay on top. Back on top with 8:07 to play.
Just is able to keep it alive, but the play continues on, and Chicago never gets back into position. And as Hedman started the play, went down low, he comes in and grabs that loose puck off the end. You know, Hedman started that thing by getting down into the loose puck, flipping it back to the point, and he's the beneficiary of that bounce.
And rolls in on goal from Marilla. Mrazek will hang on, and everybody joins the party behind the Chicago cage. Seen a few scrums like this tonight. It's 7:23 left in the third period. That's a great hockey expression. They don't call it minus, it's dash. Dash four. Here's Point with a step. What else to do? Cuts in, another big stop for Mrazek. And no rebound. Again, it just seems like Tampa is trailing by a goal. Not the other way around. Here's a chance. Kurashev in. And a save by Johansson. Perry had tied the game earlier in the period. For Hedman, put Tampa on top. Shoot in and shot right back out. Hagel with an empty net, and he'll flip it top of the net for the goal and the clincher for the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Cock puts this one away. Bedard's going to try and create some action in the offensive zone by himself as he chips it in, but Sergachev is right there, and he just flips it high out to center ice, and Hagel.
Hedman's on it there. Be a game-winning goal for Victor Hedman. Tied up back behind the cage. And the horn sounds, ending the hockey game here tonight.